children. It won't work. You have to blame yourself. وَلَا تَلُومُوا لِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourself. The shaitan will say, I am not the cause of you going to Jahannam. I just showed you the temptations. I showed you the discos. I showed you the clubs. I showed you the parties. I showed you the movies. I showed you all the bad that could be in the world, in the music, in the women, in the immodesty, in the haram. You accepted it. You ran after it. وَلَا تَلُومُوا لِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't blame me, but you blame yourself. Allah, meaning if you use the blessings of Allah against His commands, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah says, my punishment is severe. And the first of all many punishments, Allah removes happiness. Allah removes peace and tranquility in the minds of people. They will have, but inside they will be hollow. لك الحمد بالإسلام ولك الحمد بالقرآن ولك الحمد بالأهل والمال. اللهم لك الحمد وبسطت رزقنا وأظهرت أمننا وأحسنت معافاتنا ومن كل شيء ما سألناك أعطيتنا يا رب. فلك الحمد كثيرا كما تنعم كثيرا وصرفت شرا كثيرا. فلوجهك الجليل الباقي الدائم الحمد لله رب العالمين. والصلاة والسلام على سيد رحمة العالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا. إنا هديناه السبيل إما شاكرا وإما كفورا. وقال سبحانه وتعالى لقد كان لسبأ في مسكنهم آية جنتان عن يمين وشمال كلوا من رزق ربكم واشكروا له بلدة طيبة ورب غفور. فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام الطاعم الشاكر بمنزلة الصائم السابق، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed has blessed every one of us, and every human is blessed to be just a human itself, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this human virtue over many creations, where Allah says وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Human itself has been given a great virtue. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. And there are many creations that we don't even know about, that only Allah knows, but Allah has given us virtue over all that creation. And not only gave us such honor, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in the best form, where Allah says لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We created this insan in the best form, in the best look. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, above this, He did not just leave us in the best form or the best creation. In this nation that we are from, Allah says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. We made you selectively from the best of all nations. So blessing of Allah over blessings. Favor of Allah upon another, favor upon favors. Which Allah, these things we don't even recognize or realize. We don't understand these favors. And Allah says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. So being the best of all creations, and created in the best of all forms, and from the best of all nations. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the entire world, He says, كُنْ فَيَكُنْ. إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولْ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُنْ. When Allah decides to create something, He makes a command and it becomes. Be and it becomes. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this human, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not just make a command, but He had selective measures and knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the qudrat of Allah, Allah created this insan. This is why when Allah challenged and questioned Iblis, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ. مَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ. What prevented you to prostrate to something that I created with my own hands? With my own knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كَمَا يَلِقُ بِشَأْنِي. Allah not limited to forms and limbs. Allah created this human with His own knowledge. He didn't just leave him. Allah perfected the creation of every mankind. This is why Allah says, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدِي. اسْتَكْبَرْتَ. This is your pride. This is your ego. And this shaitan made a vow to Allah. فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Oh Allah, I swear by your honor, I will continue to misguide this human. I will continue to lead him astray. لَأَتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ ومن خلفهم ومن عيمانهم ومن شمائلهم ولا تجد أكثرهم شاكرين. I will come from the front, I will come from the back, I will come from the right, I will come from the left, I will come from every angle to mislead this youth, to mislead this man, this men, these women. I will do everything possible to take him away from Salat al-Mustaqim to Jannah forever, Jahannam forever. And this shaitan made this covenant, this vow to Allah. And he said, Allah, in a hadith Qudsi, Allah, he said to Allah, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ وَجَلَلِكَ. Oh Allah, I swear by your honor, by your dignity. He said, oh Allah, I swear by your honor, and I swear by your dignity. فَبِعِزَّتِكَ وَجَلَلِكَ لَأَخْوِي بَنِي آدَمْ مَا دَامَدِ الْأَرْوَحُ فِيهِ. I will continue to make effort to misguide this human as long as there's a soul living in this person. As long as he lives, I will bring money in front of him. I will bring women in front of him. I will bring fame and power and dignity, the craving, the desire to be famous and known. I will bring everything possible. His children, he will be tested by his children. He will be tested by his business. He will be in the ma'anwalikum wa'awlaadukum fitna. I will test you in every single form. And the shaitan says, I will be izzatika wa jalalik la'akhwi bani adam ma damat al-arwahu biyam. I will do my best. And then Allah replies to this Iblis, فَبِعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي, I swear by my honor, فَبِعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي لَأَبْرَعُ أَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ مَا دَمُ اسْتَغْفِرُونِي. As long as the son of Adam continues to repent to me, you can do whatever you want, I will continue to forgive him. You can make all the efforts, come from the front, come from the back, come from all angles, with all desires put in front, all the temptations they put in front of this human. As long as this human realizes that after I make a sin, I turn to Allah and I ask him for sincere repentance, Allah says, I will continue to forgive him. And this shaitan on the Day of Judgment will come, and the mankind will blame the shaitan. وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانَ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ. When the decisions have been decided, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ, the shaitan will tell mankind, Allah promised you, your Lord. He's now, the shaitan is saying this. Are you serious? The shaitan is going to tell us on the Day of Judgment, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ. Allah promised you true. His promise was true. فَخْلَقْتُكُمْ. You, وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ وَعَدْتُكُمْ فَخْلَقْتُكُمْ. You promised you, and then you disobeyed the commands of Allah. وَمَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. You can't blame me. إِلَّا دَعُوتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. I showed you the world. I showed you the temptations. I showed you the world. You were given the right path and the wrong path to decide. إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلِ إِمَّا شَاكِرْ وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. We give you the choices. You pick the way of life. فَلَا تَلُومُوا لِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't blame me. Don't blame me. You can't blame your parents on the Day of Judgment. It won't work. You can't blame your children. It won't work. You have to blame yourself. فَلَا تَلُومُوا لِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourself. The shaitan will say, I am not the cause of you going to Jahannam. I just showed you the temptations. I showed you the discos. I showed you the clubs. I showed you the parties. I showed you the movies. I showed you all the bad that could be in the world, in the music, in the women, in the immodesty, in the haram. You accepted it. You ran after it. فَلَا تَلُومُوا لِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't blame me, but you blame yourself. This is why on the Day of Judgment, Allah will say to Ibn Adam, يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا ثُمَّ أُوَفِّيكُمْ إِيَّاهَا. O son of Adam, O my slaves, these are your deeds that are presented to you, not someone else's. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَىٰ وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. We are not going to punish anyone until we send a prophet to teach them and lessons to guide them. So you are not to blame anyone else. Allah will say, إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيَا ثُمَّ وَفِيكُمْ إِيَّهَا. These are the good deeds that you did. These are the wrong that you did. And these are presented to you. فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. Whoever finds himself successful and in good hands, and he's passed the exam of Akhirah, he should be grateful to Allah. فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَلُمَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. And if he does not find himself successful in Akhirah, then he should not blame anyone but himself. So the shaitan has made this effort to misguide his best creation. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him out from the heavens, and أخرج إنك رجيم إن عليك لعنتي إلى يوم الدين قال أنذرني إلى يوم يبعثون قال إنك من المنذرين إلى يوم وقت معلوم. Allah gave him the life. Allah gave him the choices. Allah gave him the power to deceive mankind, the tricks to deceive mankind. And now it is this human's responsibility to recognize his friends and his enemies. And Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. This enemy is the devil, not no one else. Make him your enemy. Don't embrace his ways. And today, we as the Muslims, we have embraced the ways of non-Muslims. We will party Wednesday night before Thanksgiving, then have a turkey to thank God, and then again we will sleep through Fajr Salah next morning. My brothers and sisters, we cannot live the life of non-Muslims. We are Muslims and we are proud of who we are. وَلَنْ تَرْضَ عَنْكَ الْيَهُودِ وَلَنْ نَصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. Enjoy the meal, enjoy the food, but your enjoyment is not just for the evening. And gratefulness is not just for the moment, it's for every single thing that Allah has given us. Every moment that Allah has given us. Somebody said, you want to know what a blessing of Allah? Just the breath that you have, the breath that you take, the breathing capability, the power. This is the blessing of Allah. It says, you want to recognize the eyes. Close your eyes for a moment and try to see. You cannot see. Try to perceive. You cannot. You cannot recognize. Ask those women and ask those men who are born blind and never seen their relatives. And never seen their loved ones, who cannot see the Kaaba, who cannot see the grave of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who can go to Makkah and can see, and they can imagine, but they have never seen, because Allah has never given them the eyes. Ask those people who don't have eyes what eyes are. Ask those people who don't have nails. I had a friend of mine who did not have nails. When he had to open a pop can, he would ask me to open the pop can. When he had to scratch himself, he would ask someone to scratch me. You know, nails. Something that we think it's dirt, of course it needs to be cut every Friday. But such things, which are great blessings of Allah, we overlook these blessings. We don't show gratitude to the blessings of Allah. Ungrateful to these small things. What do you think about the greatest blessings? وَرُؤُسُ النِّعَمْ فَلَكْ. The greatest of all blessings are three things. Wahab ibn al-Munabbi rahimahullah says, the greatest of all blessings are three. Al-Islam. لَا تُتِمُّ الْحَيَاةِ. You cannot enjoy the ni'mah, the blessings of Allah without Islam. Islam is, Allah says, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. Before, they were blessed. Before Makkah, was also blessed. Before the Arabs were also blessed. What completed the blessings of all? What sealed the blessings? What sealed the beauty of the blessing of life? وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. And I completed my blessings upon you. What is that? وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. This Islam. Today we use this Islam and we blame this Islam. This is the means of our obstacle for our success. This is the cause of our failure. No, this is how we will attain success. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. So Islam is the greatest of all blessings. Without Islam, you really can't enjoy nothing. You can't enjoy this life, neither akhirah. And the next blessing, which is the greatest of all blessings, is afiyah. Al-afiyah, if you don't have happiness, peace. And this is something that we need to ask for Allah. Remember, there are countries that came, that we lived in. There were always peace and happiness. But today you cannot even walk safely in these countries. So afiyah, peace, security. You know, a sense that nothing will happen to me, nothing will harm me. Afiyah, fi jasad, in the body, and also in the family. This comfort and ease is something that we need to ask Allah. Sallallahu alayhi wa afiyah. Ask Allah for afiyah. Allah gives us, this is the best thing that can be given to a person بعد اليقين. عافية. اللهم إنا نسألك العفة والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة في أهلنا والأموال. Always asking Allah for happiness and peace and removing the difficulty. Then the greatest blessing after عافية. These are three things that we need to be grateful for. And then is غنى. Having wealth and prosperity. Because many people don't even have this. Many people are not able to enjoy these blessings. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, عرض علي ربي أن يجعل مطحم مكة ذهبا وفضة. Allah presented to me through Jibril alayhi wasallam to make the mountains of Mecca gold and silver. They can follow me whenever my companions need. Take a piece of this and sell it and feed them. عرض علي ربي أن يجعل مطحم مكة ذهبا وفضة. فقلت لا يا رب. I said, no my Lord. أجوع يوما وأشبع يوما. I like to live a life where I'll stay hungry one day and I'm filled with food, with your blessings one day. And that day that I'm hungry, أتضرع إليك, I turn to you and ask you. And the day you feed me, أشكرك وأحمدك. Oh Allah, I thank you for the blessings that you have given us. All these blessings that we have, you look right, you look left, you have children, you have family. Even then we complain. Are we complaining? Are we judging Allah for the things He has given us? Or are we judging Allah for the dua that has not been accepted yet? My question, are we judging Allah for the things that He has favored us with, or are we judging Allah for that one dua that has yet to be accepted? That one dua, you say, oh Allah, you don't give me. And you look at people who have more than you, and you become ungrateful. لَا تَنْظُرُوا إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ فَوْقَكُمْ وَانْظُرُوا إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ. Don't look at people who are richer than you, or wealthier than you. Then you can never stop competing. Look at those who don't have. Look at those who don't have health, who don't have wealth. Look at those who don't have children. Look at those who don't have happiness, those who don't have businesses. We're always competing with a brother or sister. His father bought a new car, you should buy a better car. We're competing. Competition. Remember, وَلَمْ يَقُولِ إِبْنَ آدَمْ مَالِي مَالِي. Ibn Adam keeps on saying, I want more wealth, more wealth. This, what Allah has given us, is not our accomplishment. إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. This is what Qarun said. This is what Qarun said. Everything is a blessing of Allah. Everything. And this is where Sulaiman alayhi salam and the Prophet Dawood alayhi salam was tested. لِيَبْلُوَنِي أَشْكُرْ أَمْ أَكْفُرْ. Allah is testing me with that kingdom, with that wealth. Am I grateful to Allah? What is the difference between shukr and hamd? Hamd is متعلق باللسان. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah الذي عافاني. Alhamdulillah الذي بنعمته تتم الصالح. You thank Allah. But shukr, Imam Qayyim al-Jawzi rahimahullah says, is linked to three things. Three. Shukr al-lisan, to thank Allah by the tongue. The shukr al-qalb, to thank Allah by the heart, thank Allah from the depth of your heart. And the most important of all is to thank Allah by your limbs. We say we are grateful to Allah for the things He has given us, but the same wealth that He's given us is being used against the law of Allah. It's used in the transgression of Allah's laws. We are breaking the limits that Allah has put, boundaries, but we're doing this. This is why, my brothers and sisters, there are people that came before us. فاستكبروا في الأرض بغير الحق وقالوا من أشد منا قوة. Hud alayhi salam told his people, remember, turn to Allah, don't be proud of what you have. They built their houses and mountains, and they were able to rip out roots of trees by their hands. They took pride in what they were, their wealth, their money, their degrees, their passion, their talents. فاستكبروا في الأرض بغير الحق. They had all of this, but they don't have the right to have pride. قالوا من أشد منا قوة. Who's better than us? Who's richer than us? Who's more powerful than us? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً. Can they not see that Allah that created them is greater and more powerful than them? And they took pride in this. Allah destroyed them. الْحَقَّ مَا الْحَقَّ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحَقَّ كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةِ فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةٍ سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا صَرْعَى كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ. Allah picked them up, smashed their heads, dropped them to the earth, and removed them from the surface of this earth. Look at the people of Saba, of Yemen. They were blessed after Sulaiman alayhi salam. Look at the tarikh and tafsir of their stories. 13 prophets came to the people of Saba and told them, they were Muslims, but they were ungrateful to Allah. Allahumma ba'id bayna asfarina. They asked for more punishment. These people, لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئِ مَسْكَنِ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ. Allah had put signs in their stories. They had gardens, they had rivers, they had dams. The land was fertile. They were rich. They had everything going perfect in their life. جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينٍ وَشِمَالٍ. Allah said, enjoy. Allah doesn't want people to take the blessings of Allah and put them on the side. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُرَى أَدْرَ نِعْمَةِ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. If Allah has given you wealth, use it. Allah has given you help, use it. Allah likes when you are blessed, you show people the blessing of Allah. A sahabi came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was Imran bin Hussein radiallahu anhu, and his clothes was just dusty, his hair was disheveled, he looked like a person that came who was a beggar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do you have wealth? He said, yes. He said, wear proper clothes, comb your hair, dress nice, look nice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُرَى أَثُرَ نِعْمَةِ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. Allah loves to see his blessings on his slave. Allah loves it. But the one is to show Allah's blessings to Allah. One is to show his blessings in pride to others. Two different. There's a fine line between takabbur and istighna. There's a fine line between takabbur and istighna. Takabbur is to be proud. I don't need anyone's business, nothing. And istighna is, I'm independent, Allah is enough for me. There's a fine line. And their attitudes can change. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the people of Saba everything. لَقَدْ كَانِ لِسَبَأٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينٍ وَشِمَالٍ كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ رَبِّكُمْ. Allah said, enjoy it. Have it. Allah said, doesn't say, don't enjoy it. Enjoy your children. Enjoy your families. But at the same time, be grateful to Allah. كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ رَبِّكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ. And this, the two good qualities these people had, they were either had رَبٌ بَلْدَةٌ طَيِّبَةٌ وَرَبٌ غَفُورٌ. Allah gave them a blessed city, a blessed town, and they were always turning to Allah. And finally, فَأَعْرَضُوا. They thought their wealth came, their possession, their material turned them away from Allah. And we can already see this in our generation. We can already see this in our families, in our kids, in our daughters. Allah has blessed them. But even then, with 4 alarm clocks, we can't give them up for salah. Allah has blessed our families, even with all these blessings, with a car heated up, with a remote start to go for salah. Everything perfect for us. Everything working well for us. Even then, it is very difficult for us to obey Allah. فَأَعْرَضُوا. They turned away from Allah. Because they thought they were independent now. They had some فَرُسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سِلْعَوْا. And Allah removed the dams. Allah sent rats to chew up the walls at the bottom of the dam. Blind rats in tafsir. To chew the walls of this dam. And after a period of time, فَرُسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah says, we let loose the water of the dam. وَبَدَّلْنَاهُمْ. And we changed the situation. ذَوَاتِ أُقْلِ الْخَمْتِ وَذِ وَشَيْءٍ مِنْ سَدٍ قَلِيلٍ ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَفَرُوا. And this is how we will treat everyone who is ungrateful. Anyone who is ungrateful to Allah, we will make their fate the same fate of these people of Saba. But if they're grateful to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more like Sulaiman. And Dawood is a لِيَبْلُوَنِي أَشْكُرَ مَقْفُرُ. So, فَلَمَّا أَتَوْا عَلَى وَادِ النَّمْرِ قَالَتْ نَمْلَةٌ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّمْلُ ادْخُلُوا مَسَاكِنَكُمْ لَا يَحْطِمَنَّكُمْ سُلَيْمَانُ وَجُنُودُهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. فَتَبَسَّمَ ضَاحِكًا مِنْ قَوْلِهِ وَقَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَاللَّهِ. And Sulaiman is moving with his وَحُشِرَ لِسُلَيْمَانَ وَجُنُودُهُ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. Allah Sulaiman is flying with the jinns, the ins, his entire kingdom would fly. وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ غُدُوُّهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make Sulaiman fly from one part of the world to the next part of the world. Allah gave him so much kingdom. This, you know, look. هَبْلِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحْدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. Allah gave him, he asked Allah, oh Allah, give me such kingdom. Somebody came to me and said, you can ask for wealth, it's not haram. Prophet Yusuf asked to become the king of Misr. Put me on the treasure of Misr. رَبِّ هَبْلِي مُلْكٍ. Oh Allah, give me kingdom. There's nothing wrong with asking for it. لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحْدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. Allah accepted that dua, became very wealthy. But his wealth did not make him run away from Allah, but made him a means of guidance for the people of Bilqis and other nations around him. Here Sulaiman is going. He goes over a valley where there are ants crawling. And so the queen of the ants tells the ant, go into your house. اُدْخُلُوا مَسَاكِنَكُمْ. And Sulaiman is salam, عَلِّمْنَا مَنْتِقَ الطَّيْرُ وَأُوتِينَا مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah gave them the understanding of animals and creatures. So Sulaiman is salam overhears this conversation of this ant, with the queen ant with other ants. Go into your house. لَا يَحْتِمَنَّكُمْ سُلَيْمَانُ وَجُنُودُهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Sulaiman is salam, فَتَبَسَّمَ ضَاحِكًا. He smiled and he laughed. من قول قال ربي أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي نمتع. He doesn't say, oh look at me, I can understand the conversation of these small creations. Right away he turns to Allah, oh Allah, make me grateful. When you are blessed, when you sit in your cars, when you see your children, say Alhamdulillah. When you breathe, when you come back from work, say Alhamdulillah. How many more physicians are they? They don't have jobs. How many youth who are going to colleges, they don't have parents to support them. You are at the support. You have the help. Say Alhamdulillah. Thank Allah. Be grateful to Allah. This is the jungle. Allah wants to see it. Allah loves it when people are grateful to Allah. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. You are grateful, Allah will give you more. It's not a turkey that shows gratefulness to Allah. It is your life. Your life. How well you are. We are not going to adopt the styles of the Christians and the Americans. We want them to adopt the style of Muhammad and his Habib, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We want them to adopt this style because this is the way of salvation, not their way. So he says, and then he asked, there's a long conversation that took between Sulaiman and this Naman. Sulaiman says, Sam goes to this Naman and tafsir this ayah. He says, أَمَا تَعْرِفْ أَنِّي نَبِيٌّ مَلِكٌ. Don't you know I'm a prophet of Allah? And عَادِلٌ. I will never kill you on purpose. لَا يَحْطِمَنَّكُمْ. The scientists say, حَطُمْ is something that means crush. You can only crush glass. The researchers say, inside every single ant there is a particle of glass. So Allah used the word, لَا يَحْطِمَنَّكُمْ. Don't let Sulaiman and his army crush you. جنود وهم لا يشعرون and they won't even know. So the answer to Suleiman, إنما أردت حكم النفوس. I didn't think and I wasn't saying they will crush your bodies, but I was thinking, telling my ants, when they will see your kingdom, the ants, my ants, when they will see your massive kingdom, they will become ungrateful to Allah. Oh Allah, you give Suleiman such a big kingdom and that's nothing. I told them to go down so they don't see this, so they can be grateful to Allah. Suleiman says, wow, what a wise ant. He said, Usini, now a great prophet, great scholar, great knowledge, you know. He says, Imam Ghazali rahimahullah says, khuyira Suleiman bayn al-ilmi wal-ma. He was given a choice between knowledge and wealth. فَاخْتَارُ الْعِلْمِ فَآتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا وَعِلْمًا. He was given a choice between wealth and knowledge. He said, oh Allah, give me knowledge. Allah gave him both. Allah gave him both. Be sincere in it. So Suleiman says, give me some advice. Then he says, do you know why your father, لِمَاذَا سُمِّيَ أَبُوكَ دَاوُودُ? Do you know why your father was named Dawood? So I don't know. What kind of question is that? لِأَنَّهُ دَاءَ جَرَحَاكَ قَلْبِي. Because he cured the sickness of his heart. Dawood. Do you know why your name is Suleiman? He says, I don't know why my name is Suleiman. He says, لِأَنَّكَ سَلِيمَ الْقَلْبِ. Because your heart is pure. Your father cured the hearts, and you have a pure heart. Then he says, do you know why Allah gave you control of the wind and the do you know why? To let you know, this world is like the wind. It never stays. Some people rule it, and then their life goes on, and some other rulers come, and everyone dies. So, these people leave this world. My point of my khutbah is, brothers and sisters, to be grateful to Allah is not just by the tongue or by an evening or by a weekend. It's to be grateful to Allah for everything and every moment of our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us really grateful to Allah and by His obedience in serving Him, serving His deen, using our wealth and our time to serve His deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعين ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. And the first thing of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to recognize His favor. Number two is to thank Allah every single day after salah when you see His favors. And then number three is not to use the favors Allah has given someone against Allah. So if a father gives a phone to a child, to use it against the father's law. The father says, don't make any bad calls, don't use the internet for anything immodest. Now this son is using it to harm himself, harm his family. So now he's being ungrateful for the blessing that his father has given him. Equally, all the blessings that Allah has given us, we cannot use it against it. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَكُمْ وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ. This kafara doesn't mean to deny Allah's oneness. If you are ungrateful to Allah, meaning if you use the blessings of Allah against His commands, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah says, my punishment is severe. And the first above all many punishments, Allah removes happiness. Allah removes peace and tranquility in the minds of people. They will have, but inside they will be hollow. This is why, my brothers and sisters, to remember, never look at a sin, just it's just a sin. لَا تَنْظُرْ إِلَى صَغْرِ الذُّنُوبِ وَلَكِنْ ظُرْ إِلَى مَنْ عَصَيْتِ. Never look at the smallness of a sin, but rather look at the great one who your sin disobeyed. Don't look, oh, it's just this, this is, there's no such thing as just in the court of Allah when it comes to sinning. You cannot do this. He says, بِقَدْرِ مَا يُعْظَمُ ذَنْبَكَ عِنْدَكَ يُزْغَرُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. فَضْلِ ابْنِ عِيَاذ رَحِمَهُ says, the more the sin is waiting, the more you carry a sin in your eyes, I can't believe I made this sin. The more you think of the sin being great in your eyes, the smaller it is in the eyes of Allah. بِقَدْرِ مَا يُزْغَرُ عِنْدَكَ يُعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And you might have hurt somebody's feelings. You're like, my astaghfirullah, I can't believe I said this to him. And you have this guilt in the eyes of Allah, Allah will forgive you after you apologize to him. But some people say the worst things to him. You know what they say? He deserves it. Deserves it. Who are you to say he deserves this attitude? Are you the Rabb? Do you know the Asrar? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. We need to be grateful to Allah. And the sign of being grateful to Allah is that whatever we have, oh Allah, I don't deserve it. It's your favor. And the sign of pride is, oh Allah, I deserve it. I deserve more. I deserve more. We don't deserve all this. Who are we? We sin day and night. But Allah says, you know what? Enjoy life. Enjoy life. And I finish with a poem that a poet says, Wallahi, لو علموا قبيح سريرتي. Wallahi, if people knew that the sins within us, لأبى السلام عليك من تلقاني. No one will shake our hands. No one will ever greet us. نشرت لي في العالمين محامد حتى جعلت جميعهم إخواني. We thank Allah. Oh Allah, you are the one that has hidden our faults and covered our sins and distributed and opened our goodness to people, and everyone is saying salam, and everyone greets everyone like a brother. May Allah enjoy giving us more in this world. May Allah bless us, protect us, and give us more aman in the Muslim countries. Remove all the difficulties. Let us enjoy the happiness of others also. Not only our happiness. Allahumma aghfir li jami'i al-muslimina wal-muslimat wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat wal-ahya'i minhum al-amwal innaka sami'un qareeb mujibud da'wat. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-'afwa wal-'afiya fi dunya wal-akhirah fi ahlina wa amwalina wa fi dinina wa dunyana. Allahumma ij'al lisanana shukura, Allahumma ij'al badana subura, Allahumma ij'al abdana subura, Allahumma ij'al lisanana dhakira wa qalban shukura ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna wa ma asrarna wa ma 'alanna wa ma anta 'alim bihi minna fa anta al-muqaddim wa anta al-mu'akhir wa anta 'ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allahumma ansur al-muslimina fi الشام وفي مصر وفي برما وفي سائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم كن معهم. اللهم ارنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم ارنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم انصرهم عاجلا يا رب العالمين. امين امين امين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني اذكركم واشكروني واتقوا.